सीवाय मैथमेटिक्स ना आपणे 503 માં ચેપ્ટર નંબર આપણના કોમ્પ્લેક્સ ફંક્શન વિશે આપણે ડિસ્કસ કરવા જઈ રહ્યા છીએ. આપણે પાર્ટ 1 માં કોમ્પ્લેક્સ ફંક્શન નો બેઝિક જે છે મિત્રો એની ચર્ચા સૌપ્રથમ આપણે કરીએ. તો કોમ્પ્લેક્સ ફંક્શન સિમ્પલી કોમ્પ્લેક્સ ફંક્શન જે છે એને આપણે ઝેડ વડે ડિનોટેટ કરતા ફોર ટુ વેરિયેબલ સિમ્પલ એક્સ પ્લસ આઈ વાય. એક્સ પ્લસ આઈ વાય. તો મિત્રો આપણા ચેપ્ટર નંબર આ થર્ડ કોમ્પ્લેક્સ ફંક્શનમાં સૌપ્રથમ કોમ્પ્લેક્સ ફંક્શનનું બેઝિક જે છે જે તમે સ્ટાન્ડર્ડ 12 થી શીખી ગયેલા છો, કોમ્પ્લેક્સ ફંક્શન ઝેડ ઇક્વલ ટુ એક્સ પ્લસ આઈ વાય. તો અહીંયા ઝેડ જે છે આપણા માટે કોમ્પ્લેક્સ ફંક્શન થશે. x જે છે એ આપણા માટે રીઅલ પાર્ટ આપણે કહેતા હતા અને y જે છે એને આપણે ઇમેજનરી પાર્ટ ત્યાં કહેતા હતા કે ઇમેજનરી પાર્ટ. તો હિયર વી આર ડિસ્કસિંગ ધ કોમ્પ્લેક્સ ફંક્શન બટ ઇન ધ ફોર્મ ઓફ ફંક્શન. સો z x એન્ડ y here x is the function of any one variable, y is the another function of any one variable. Here x is the real function, here imaginary function, and the combination of both x plus i y, which one we are denoted the f of z. So here complex function is becoming f of z equal to f of x plus i y. So here x plus i y we are changing the form f of u and v. So f of z equal to x plus i y. X plus i y or u plus i v, we are denoted u plus i v. So here u plus u x y, f of z equal to x plus i y in which u x y, f of z equal to u x y plus only z plus I v x y, which one meaning u x y function of x y, v x y function of x y, which one we get any form u x y. Suppose u x y equal to any x square minus x y here. So x minus y square we have taken, v x y suppose any other function of x and y variable. Here suppose x cube minus y cube. Then the combination of both u and v, we are getting the f of z complex function, which one x minus y square plus I here x cube minus y cube. Then this one is the u and this one is the v. Here is the real part and this one is the imaginary part, and here the complex function, because complex function is the sum of real and imaginary parts. So here mitro module f of z value, mod f of z, which one under root x square plus y square. Remember mod of f of z equal to under root x square plus y square. I mean under root real part of square plus imaginary part square. Ready? Both sum are in under root, which one given us to module of z. It means mod of z. Ready? This one is the basic of complex function. Complex function, which one we are denoted the f of z. Here the simple way, in simple variable form x and y, but we are discussing in the function form. So f of z equal to u plus i v. Here the u is the function of x y and v is also the function of x y. Ready? So here u and v, u is the real part and v is the imaginary part. Okay. Next, We are discussing about the limit of complex function. So, limit of complex function. Suppose, Mitro, f of z is defined in neighborhood of deleted neighborhood of z0. I mean, f of z is defined in deleted neighborhood of set 0. F of z is defined in deleted neighborhood of z0. It means the f of z is Mitro. z0 ની આજુબાજુ વ્યાખ્યાયિત છે then neighborhood of z0 and z0 belongs to C. C is the all complex range Mitro. z0 it belongs to C then and also w0 is complex function. W0 is complex function and also delta greater than 0 and we are getting epsilon greater than 0 here delta greater than 0 and also epsilon greater than 0 delta greater than 0 implies we are getting the epsilon greater than 0 એટલે epsilon આપણને એવો મળે કે જેથી મિત્રો કઈ કન્ડિશન સેટિસ્ફાઈડ થાય તો કે 0 less than z minus z0 મોડ્યુલ એટલે કે મિત્રો એનો મોડ લઈએ આપણે મિત્રો less than delta implies f of z minus w0 another function we are complex function w0 less than epsilon then we are said that the f of z tends to z0 implies f of z tends to w0. It means Mitro k w0 is complex function and we are denoted that f of z as z0. It means k limit z tends to z0 implies z tends to z0 then f of z tends to equal to w0. It means w0. Z tends to z0 implies f of z tends to w0, where w0 is another complex function, and we have said that z tends to z0 in between 0 to delta, and f of z minus w0 less than epsilon. It means the limit of z tends to z0, we are getting the w0. So, here, Mitro, limit of complex function. Definition of limit is f of z is defined in neighborhood of z0 and we are getting the another complex function w0 and also the delta and epsilon greater than 0 then z tends to z0 implies f of z tends to w0 then w0 is complex function and w0 is the limit of our complex function. Next, Mitro, continuous and derivative function. There are three conditions that f of z be a continuous. Continuous function. Suppose f of z be a continuous function. Function, then f of z is continuous function, then three conditions will be satisfied. Three condition is first limit z tends to z0 f of z is exist. First one, limit z tends to z0 f of z is exist. x0. Second one, z0 is x0. Mitro, f of z, z tends to z0, then limit z tends to z0, but z0 is x0, then and then f of z is continuous function. Z0 is x0. And third one, limit z tends to z0, okay, limit z tends to z0, f of z. Equal to z0. Here, limit z tends to z0, f of z, equal to epsilon 0. It means here another complex function z0 exists. Limit z tends to z0, f of z, equal to z0. That means f of z is continuous function. It means if given three conditions satisfied, f of z is exist, f of z0 is exit, and output, it means limit z tends to z0, we are getting the z0, then it means continuous function. F of z is continuous function in neighborhood of deleted z0. Ready? In neighborhood of z 0, f of z is continuous function if these three conditions are satisfied, then this one is the sense continuous function. So complex function, limit of complex function, and continuity function, continuous function, there are three conditions. And next,